for this wonderful insight. I ever wondered, like, Ajay should come and tell, like, something which is coming from, like, behind courtroom. So, sir, my question is there something which of this kind going at district level, in the minds of district judges? Because I remember a judge who was saying to me that whatever we write, like judgment, is a fourth carbon copy of two events. Like witnesses are there, and then prosecution telling their story, and defendant side again coming up their story, and then in the end judge writes his own like view, like the what he sees or she sees about that. And second, that do we need to those judges at that level, they should go and do this, they should be more like going out and beyond the rules which they were seen as. I don't know how to frame this question, but just to give you an account from a judge where police arrests someone and someone complained to CGM, and CGM goes there and in the police station, because police always say, no, no, we have not arrested so and so person. Things of that sort, sir.
The subordinate courts are the face of judiciary for a common man. Actually, my friend, Mr. Ahluwalia, Justice Ahluwalia, who is in Rajasthan, used to say his brother was a simple person. So he was asking when his, Mr. Ahluwalia became a judge, will he be as big as our sessions judge? So he was trying to tell him, no, I co-judge. But then, will they give you a big house like the district judge? For this life, it can be nothing bigger than the district judge. It is like in Ramakrishna Paraman's story, a frog in the well. It had not gone out of the well. So there was a frog which came from, which had in the ocean, and it had come. So this, when this new frog came, so this frog in the well said, it jumped and said, is your ocean this big? So he said, the ocean frog said, no, 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 it is bigger. Then it jumped from one end to another and said, will it be that big? No, it is even bigger than that. It just could not conceive that could be anything bigger than that. It is something like that. See, for people in the subordinate courts, they have such immense value for what they do. But they don't know how strong they are, what they need to do. They settle for something very simple, cite some case law here, there, and then it's all over. Their attempt to get the truth, somewhere this is where I think it's lacking, that you don't really go after. If that fact is missed, if truth is missed at the trial court, it is impossible to secure it at the higher court. So therefore, a greater responsibility must be felt. We must trust our subordinate officers more. But from what I have seen in the High Court, there is always the kind of treatment which you hold out to the subordinate judges is never very is never good. You will find them coming to the railway stations or at the airports. In Chennai, in the heat of April or May, you will find a person wearing a black coat and standing for a judge who is passing through that if he is going by train, and that is what would happen. The subordinate judge's strength is really the strength of the judiciary. If you ask me, if the judges in the subordinate courts are strong enough, they are not. But I think there is a whole new thing which is happening. Judges are being the judge career is seen as an important option now of what did not exist before. For a long time, persons who did not have briefs will take to judiciary. persons who are not making enough monies in crores were taken to be judges. Not any longer. I find in Punjab or in Haryana or in Delhi, or Delhi for instance, the most brilliant, the brilliant persons are persons who are coming into judiciary. Because everything is in some way taken care of. You have a good house, you have a good thing to, you can arrange your life easily. And then it's an empowering position. To be at a position to judge others is a great thing. That's a great blessing. So therefore, I think we should, if amongst you, some of you will become judges at a young level, entry at an entry point. I think it's a greatest contribution can happen. Many of us, what happens is we are opting for the corporate life, but then such of you who want also litigation as an area, you should be there judges, us judges. That should surely happen. I'm not too sure whether I understood your question fully and responding to it, but I'm generally understanding the status of the subordinate judiciary and the kind of importance which has to be given.
Sir, I'm not sure if this question really has an answer, but this question comes from a perspective that when I was working in the courts for my internships, I was always told that the judges in the higher judiciary who are elevated from the lower judiciary are not as good as the judges who are appointed after being senior advocates or they've served in the bar. The question is that is there a difference in the world views of a person coming from the lower judiciary to the higher judiciary and a person being in the bar and then being elevated to the higher judiciary? Is there a difference of world views?
It is still a prevalent practice in Bombay bar, particularly senior counsel who will refuse to appear before the service judges. They are called as the service judges. Some of those judges who get drafted from the lower judiciary is the service judge, then other judges are judges. So therefore, many people refuse to argue before them. It is true. Again, it's a kind of exposure. I will not see, if you say J.S. Verma, would you ever see him to be inferior to anyone? He was a person drawn from the Lord Judiciary. He was the district judge who became the Chief Justice of India, probably one of the most sensitive judges ever. Amadi was a judge from the Lower Judiciary. A. Varadarajan was a judge from the Lower Judiciary. Nagapan was a judge from the Lower Judiciary. These are people who went to the Supreme Court. I will not put them all at the same, I will not see them at the same level of efficiency, but I am saying, but they have been great judges. Probably even the most prolific, H.R. Khanna, I'm not too sure, he was a district judge. He began as an additional district judge. So there have been eminent Supreme Court judges who have been drawn from the lower judiciary. But I say, and I must share my own, I should be honest to you, I found several judges who were drawn from the subordinate judiciary to be not as smart. It is true. Because the High Court operates with a different set of rules. You don't really at all times worry about, in a writ jurisdiction, worry about small rules and procedures. Where a person who is drawn from the subordinate judiciary is invariably worried about all procedures. For that is how he is trained to think. The civil procedure and the criminal procedure is all that sets his parameters for functioning, with the boundaries within which he has to function. Growing out of it, it requires a new hat to wear, and it gets to be not very easy for everyone to do. So therefore, in the composition of any court, it is 60-40, and now it's one-third, it's stated. In some courts, it is 60-40, 40 from the service. So 33%, one-third at least, are from the subordinate judiciary. There is another reason why it happens. While a person who is drawn from the bar has a longer tenure to work, therefore they go to a division bench, they lead the bench. The district judges or the subordinate judges who come to the High Court, they come at the fag end of the time. The fag end means, again, another way of looking at life. They are invariably a junior partner there to a judge who controls the court. It happens even in the Supreme Court. If you go, you'll know who is the judge who has just now joined the Supreme Court and who is not. For one will completely control the court, the other will be silent. In his own court, he would have roared, but that man, if he comes to the Supreme Court, he'll be moved for quite a few months. So therefore, the district judges who have a short tenure to work, they don't really have sufficient time to completely bloom and to unfold themselves. They have 2 years, 3 year tenure, and therefore you just say, I agree. So therefore, there are I agree judges more than judges who have had independent views to express. That can probably account for that, but I'm sure that there are enough and brilliant judges in the subordinate judiciary. Not all of them make it to the High Court or the Supreme Court. And it is sure to change, and that's what I think is happening now in some of the states, my experience. Yes.
Sir, I have two questions for you. So the first being, do you believe that the judicial system in India requires significant reform? And if you had to suggest one reform for the judiciary, what would it be? And the second being, I noticed that you quoted or referred to Kafka's trial and over the course of this lecture also referred to other literary pieces. And since we're studying law and literature this semester, I wanted to ask you if you believe that there is an interplay in the law and literature, and where exactly, how exactly you view this.
Okay. The first question was on the need for reforms. Do I believe that there is a need for judicial reforms? Is there anyone here who would say that it does not require reforms? So therefore, everyone experiences it. The experience comes through the kind of mediocrity that exists amongst the judiciary. That is what, for me, the most serious handicap now. If there is a deficit about a judiciary, the deficit is our mediocrity in courts. It's unbelievable. Be it in the Supreme Court or the High Court, half the judges don't know what is happening. They're clueless what is happening in courts. And you can beat them hollow anywhere on any dialogue or a debate. That is the truth. Because many of them arrive from various ways, which is not correct. And that is probably what is now taking the interest of ever so many persons. The judicial reform must begin with the system of selecting judges. Where is the doubt about it? The selection of what happens now today, you'll find the person who makes it to the Chief Justice of India or someone there in the 1, 2, 3 will be persons who will be sons of some big persons. They are sons, their sons, daughters, cousins, juniors of these people who make it. So therefore, the system of selection of judges is extremely suspect. If somebody turns out to be a judge somewhere in the High Court directly drawn from the bar, it is due to fortuitous circumstances which you can ask and secure. You ask me later how he became a judge, I'll tell you how all it happened. How at every time where my name would go, will there be somebody who will say something and then you'll get dropped. You need to have some persons to support you right through. And you'll have to keep your name afloat, otherwise it'll get dropped. So therefore, our system, it's very, very arbitrary. The choice of judges goes wholly by nepotism and by persons who are simply not fit to be judges. That is the truth. It may not take an expression outside, for I could be hauled up for contempt, but I'm sure I'm not doing as something like what Karman is doing. A name which is so similar. It's phonetically similar that I get all funny calls and messages from my friends. Now tell me what that R, if it goes a little more, I'm condemned. It's just that R stays there. Without it, I'm able to succeed in my life meeting of persons. Like Jetmalani's letter is going, doing the rounds. How did that person become a judge? Did anyone ask? You will ask me later, I'll tell you. So this is what is the danger. You allow for persons to simply come in anywhere. Now how are they? And they'll use all the cards which are inappropriate at inappropriate times. And therefore, Jetmalani has said, now you're doing something which will do harm to those classes of persons. And there are brilliant persons are there. Don't do something which will cause harm. And that is what? You'll be a harm. How did, has anyone, in fact, it happened in the judge's case when the amendment was talked about. the Chief Justice, not the Chief Justice, the person who was heading the bench asked the question to the Attorney General, where did we make a mistake? We were at all times prepared to select immediately. We have accepted, we have allowed for all intrusions to come through the executive comments. We have taken this very seriously. Tell us, he didn't know what was in store. The next day, Attorney General came up with names. You tell us how these judges got appointed. It was a shock.